Once again, very good morning, my dear students. Dear students, after the end of primary auxiliary verbs, the topic that I am going to start today is one of the most prominent topic of English grammar, which is none other than modal. It is also the part of the topic that we are continuing in these days, the verbs. Dear children, if you want to speak English very fluently and in a very decorative way, then my dear children, you must need to have a great command on the topic that I am going to teach you today, morals. Dear children, morals are helping verbs, which is also known as modal auxiliary verbs, right? Now, let me define it first of all. Morals are those auxiliary verbs, you can also say helping verbs, which express the mode or manner of the actions indicated by the main verbs. Right? Dear children, morals are those auxiliary verbs, or you can speak helping verbs, which express the mode or manner. In this line, let me explain you the word mode and manner. My dear children, mode means how something is done or the way to do something, okay, of the actions indicated by the main verbs, right? Now, let me tell you, morals express modes such as ability, possibility, permission, obligation, etc. Okay? Moral expresses modes such as ability, possibility, permission, obligations. Dear children, ability means something that we are capable to do. Okay. Possibility means like a chance to happen something. Permission means if I want to do something, I need to ask permission to somebody else. And where obligation means that a duty or responsibility. Right? Let me give you some of the examples by which you can learn all these words: ability, possibility, permission, obligations, where very carefully according to these definitions. Dear children, if I am telling you, we can speak in English. We can speak in English. What does it mean? We can speak in English. It means what? It's our ability that we can speak in English. So, dear children, this sentence and the modal verb shows the ability in the sentence. Okay. Let's see the another example. It might rain in the evening. It might rain in the evening. Dear student, in this sentence, there's nothing ability is concerned about. There is the role of possibility, a chance, a perception, right? It means this sentence belongs to possibility. Okay, now let me give you another example for permission. May I use your pen? May I use your pen? It means what? I want to use the pen of others. And that's why I'm asking the permission from the others that if he or she will permit me, then I will use his or her pen. Okay? So, the sentence belongs to permission. Okay, now the next example that I'm going to give you is you must do your duty. You must do your duty. It means what? The sentence is reflecting, you can say, a responsibility, a duty that which is necessary to be done. Okay? So, the sentence is related to obligation. Okay? Now, over here, my dear children, I have already explained to you about the models and the expressions of modes by the models. Now, I am going to tell you about the uses of models, right? The next point, or you can say the next topic that I am going to discuss over here usage of models, right? Dear children, the place where we can use models, the first, a models does not change according to the number or person of the subject, right? Dear children, you need to note down that a model does not change according to the number or person of the subject. It means it is completely free from the rule of subject. It is completely free from the rule of number and person. Let's see the example. We can play They can play. I can play. He can play. Okay. In these sentences, my dear children, you can see the modal auxiliary verbs, which is can, is over here. It doesn't get changed according to the number or person of the subject, right? Let's see the other. A model is always used with, a model is always, don't get confused over here. You can also speak a model auxiliary verbs. It will be not wrong. It is not going to be incorrect. A model is always used with a verb in its basic form. Basic form means, my dear children, the V1 form. V1 form. The model takes the tense, while the main verb, remains in its basic form. Okay, let's see the example. I can speak. In the next example, you can see, I could speak right. In these two examples, dear children, modal auxiliary verbs get changed according to tense, but the principal verb or the main verb remain its in original form, like speak and speak. Okay, let's see the other. Models can be used alone in response to a question. It means a modal verb, the word is completely sufficient to answer a question, right? Let's see the example. Do you know, children, example helps a reader to learn the given statement very easily. Okay, that's why I'm giving a lot of examples. Like, can you speak? If suppose the question is, can you speak? English? Can you speak English? I can. Let's see over here. If somebody is asking to you, can you speak English? You need not to answer complete that, yes, I can speak English. If you will answer, I can. It means what? It gives the meaning of the complete answer that you have the ability to speak English or you can speak English, right? Let's see the other example. Will you play? I will. Or I won't, you can also say. It means what? If somebody is asking to you, will you play? You need not to answer complete that, yes, I will play. If you will answer only, I will, it means you are agree and you will play, right? Let's see the other. Models when joined with not to form a negative can be contracted. It means what? Model when joined with not to form a negative can be contracted. Right? Let's see the example and after that I will explain it to you. Suppose if I'm saying I cannot sing. If I don't want to speak the complete word that I cannot sing, in place of using cannot, my dear children, I can also say I can't sing. Okay. That's the statement means to say that models when joined with not to make the sentence negative can be contracted. It means it can be separated, right? Let's see the other example. Let's see the other example. I do not sing. I do not sing. It means what? In place of using I do not sing, my dear children, I can also say that I don't sing. Will it be wrong? Of course not. I don't sing, right? So, my dear children, in this lecture, I have explained to you about the models and in the way it expresses modes such as ability, possibility, permission, obligation. Then I have explained to you its separate examples, and after that I have also explained you the usage of models, right?